Today we're going to talk about how to install the Tmc5160 on the BigTreeTech SKR version 1.4. Now, as you can see, the chip is right in the center of the frame, so I'm going to zoom in on this for a second. And as you can see, there's a little bit of writing on it that says SPI. That is actually the Spi connector right here. So the other thing I need to point out is that your enable pin is located here, and the actual wiring or configuration of this is a little bit more sturdy than the normal steppers that we have. So I'm gonna walk you through how to set this up. So the first thing that we need to do is actually look at the board. Pardon me, I'll bring it back up here. And we have to know what the stepper configuration is for our X stepper port. So this is our X stepper, our Y stepper, our Z stepper, our E0, and our E1. Now the thing that we need to realize about this is I'm actually shooting this currently without a heat fin to wick away the heat. So that would look something like this. It actually comes with it, but I'm not using it at the moment so you can see more clearly how it looks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna hook up the power to this. Now my configuration right now is not in the correct position. So for VCC power, I need to move over to here. I also need to look up how to set this up. So I'm not going to plug anything in just yet, but I'm going to go over to the web browser so you can see what I'm talking about. And what this is actually going to talk about is actually the configuration that we need to set up for this. So I'll show you what I have in the browser here. Excuse me. So down here is the manual. This is on the BigTreeTech GitHub page. And I'm scrolling down kind of quickly. I'm trying to find where the steppers are. So the first steppers we see are step dir, and it talks about what pins need to be jumped. But the one that we're working with is actually SPI. So what you see here is UART, so we're not using that either. But then further down, it has the TMC driver SPI mode, which is these jumpers here. So we're going to go back to the board and make sure that those are in place. So on the board, as you can see right over here, we have jumpers on each and every one of those. So we can hook up our actual stepper. So the trick to this is it's yellow on one side and black on the other. So we know that the orientation is going to be this way as well as the enable pin. So once we have that configured, we can plug this in because this currently will not be powered in the jumper configuration that it's currently in. And then we have to hook up the actual power supply. So what I have here is two connection ferrules for my power supply. One is black, one is red, and these are covered with a special crimp that allows the wires to maintain their placement. That way you don't get a short circuit that may damage your board or your power supply. So to hook this up, all you have to do is slide it right into here. And notice how on top I put a red mark and no mark. The red mark means voltage, so red matches that, and black matches the no mark. That way I don't accidentally plug it in backwards. So I'm gonna tighten these down, and that'll give a nice secure connection. Now that that's secure, what I'm going to do is I'm also going to plug in the actual connection for the NEMA 17 stepper. Now you can use other steppers with this, such as the NEMA 23, but I thought this would be the most basic example of how to use it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go over and load the firmware so that we can actually manipulate this and set it up correctly. So what I need to do is go over to VS Code. So I'm going to click on VS Code, and I'm going to see over in the upper left hand corner there's something for the Explorer. So I'll show you what that looks like. So in the upper left-hand corner, you have your Explorer. I'll click on that. Then I'll do Open Folder. Then I'll go to my Downloads folder. Then I'll go to Marlin 2. Then I'll do it again. Then I'll select the folder. Inside here, I have to set up the configuration for my board. So I'm going to go to Marlin. Then I'm going to go to Source. Then I'm going to go to Core. Then Boards.h. Inside Boards.h, I'm going to search on SKR underscore 1.4. Now, we have several ones that pop up, but because we're using the turbo version in this case, we have to remember our chipset of LPC1769. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to close out of here. I'm going to minimize core and source, and then I'm going to go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'm going to search on motherboard. And the default configuration, I'm going to paste over with what we just copied for the turbo. And I'm also going to change the serial port to -1. Excuse me. I'm also going to search now on the A4988. And as you can see, we have our X type stepper here. So I'm going to remove the comment to enable it. And I also have to copy the actual stepper type so I can place it in here. So once that's in place, we can configure our actual steps. There's a default of 80, and this will make sense in a second when I explain it. When you go over to configuration advanced.h, you're gonna search on 800 to get you where you need to be. And this is our current X stepper. So the configuration for this is somewhat different. So you see how there's 16 here? That equates to 80. So if we were to change 80 to 160, that would mean we have to change the actual 16 to 32. If we were to change this to a higher degree of step of 320, that would mean we'd need to change this to 64. And then if we were to even go higher, like 640, then we would need to change this to 128. And as you can tell, it should be able to go to 256, but we'll leave that for now. The other issue is we have to set our resistor sense. And after doing some research, I found it's 0.075 is the actual setting for this stepper type. So once that's configured, we need to do a search on TMC debug so that we can set up our debugging just in case there's issues. So we're going to remove the comment for monitor driver status. And we're also going to remove the comment for TMC debug. And the reasoning for this is kind of simple. As you can see, there's an M122 for a G code. That's a way to tell what the status of the stepper is. So I'm going to go back to the first one for a second, and I'm going to show you that there's other G codes over here. These are other things that you can set on the fly, but I'm not going to show you how to do that right now. I'm just going to show you that they exist. Now, the last thing we need to set is actually TMC software. So it's TMC, hang on a second, I'm having trouble typing, SW. And over here for TMC underscore use underscore software or SW underscore spy, we need to remove the comment as well. That'll enable spy for us. And then there's other various settings that you can set, but I'm going to skip over those for now because I just want to show you how to get this up and running. So the next thing we need to configure is actually our platform io.ini. And right now the default chipset is the Mega 2560. Now earlier I said the LPC 1769, and I'll show you where that is. And that's actually our chipset. So we're gonna copy this, and then we're gonna go back to that file and we're gonna change it for our default configuration. So it's a default environment, so we'll paste it right here. Now before we actually build, what we need to do is actually clean with that little garbage can, just in case there's another build in there. We don't want it to cause issues with our build. The other thing I'm going to have to show you is I have to plug this in. So I'm going to go back over to the workbench for a second. And on the workbench, I'm going to actually take the plug and plug it in, because we're not using USB power. So we need to use board power instead. If you're nervous doing that, then you don't need to use the plug, but you could use the actual jumper to enable your USB. So now that that's enabled, I'll show you what it first looks like when the USB drive comes up. So let me just bring it up real quick here for you. Over here, we have our firmware.cur. That is our current firmware that was from our last load. In this case, we're going to monitor that when we do a build, and I'll show you why just in a second. So over here, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to click on the upload button, because we're connected via USB, and this should compile or build all the individual files that we need, and then upload the firmware.bin. Now, there appears to be an error that's occurring here. So one of the things you can do is you can check to see what the first error is. And it looks like there's something going on with the .pio folder. So I'm going to do another clean. And then I'm going to do an upload again and see if this problem goes away. Now usually it goes away, but if there's an issue, it may mean that you need to start from scratch from a brand new Marlin firmware download, because something might be corrupted. It's the best way to find the error, or you can trace it out inside the actual IDE. So this built correctly in about 24 seconds. Obviously the times may vary depending upon the computer that you're using. And so what we need to do now is actually check and see what it looks like for the actual file that was copied over. So I'm going to go over here, and you can see that firmware.bin actually did copy over. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to go over to the workbench for a second. And on the workbench, I'm going to pull the power for the PSU or power supply unit. And we're going to give that a second to discharge. Then we're going to plug it back in and allow the firmware to load. So you may see a flashing light on top of your board where the firmware is loading. But what we can do to confirm that it actually loaded is we can go over to our drive and see what's going on. So if I were to bring up the drive in just a second, you'd see what is actually occurring. So over here, the previous build that we just did a couple minutes ago is now firmware.cur, which means that it loaded correctly and renamed itself to firmware.cur from firmware.bin. So to test this, we're going to go over to the workbench for a second, and we're actually going to bring up Pronterface. So inside Pronterface, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to connect to it, but right now it says COM port 1, which means that it's the normal COM port for our computer. And then there's COM port 13. So I'm unsure of which one it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to pull up Device Manager. So if I type in Device Manager and then bring it up over here, you can see where the COM ports are. So it does say COM port 13, so that's the correct COM port. So I'm going to close that down, and what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to connect with COM port 13 right here. And to check the actual debug, to make sure it's working, you can type M122 and press enter. And if all goes well, it should say okay. So now let's test to see if it's moving. Now remember, this doesn't do sensorless homing at the moment for its current configuration. So we're gonna move forward and see what happens for 10 millimeters. and it moves. Now we'll move backwards 10 millimeters, then try 20, and it appears to work fine. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.